What's good? I'm Shiro and welcome to Shonen VR. So today we are discussing My Hero Academia, chapter 313. I went to see my analytics and I saw that more than 19% of people watching my channel are not subscribed. So please, if you want to help your boy grow this channel, don't forget to subscribe so I can reach my first goal of 100 subscribers. Thanks. Pretty straightforward chapter that is more action focused, but we get some important information and maybe the end of the fight. Let's talk about it. This chapter has two main focus, Deku and All Might. I love how cool the both of them were. Let's start with All Might. As we all, or maybe most of us, knew All Might was fine because of the Might Mobile. Or should I say, Hercules. All Might, I love you. This man is so over the top. How can anyone slander or not like this character? It's beyond me. Anyway, we see that All Might tell Endeavor and Co. about the situation and jump out of the car. And he didn't jump like a bum. No, this man had a particular landing.
You're gonna do a superhero landing. Wait for it. Superhero landing.
The criminals definitely aren't high tier villains, and I think All Might can fight them, especially with this suitcase. With this suitcase.
Suitcase.
It better be something a la Iron Man. All Might though, the goat still has this overwhelming presence, and I love that. You all need to put respect on All Might's name, right, Anitreater? I see you. Anyway, that panel was giving me straight Stan vibes. To tell you all the truth, I really don't know what's gonna be the outcome of this arc. I have something in mind, but I don't want that to happen. What I have in mind is that All Might is gonna die or gonna be captured, and Deku is gonna lose because of this reckless use of the third quirk. Since we are talking about the third quirk, let's get into the Deku part of this chapter. First of all, the paneling is so good. It seems like the danger sense style of paneling is a permanent addition, and I take it. It's cool as fuck. Both Deku and Lady Nagant are smart, but Deku came on top with his big brain. I'm so proud of him. He took care of guard by using the third quirk. And the third quirk is named Fajin. From what I gathered, it's a martial art technique that lets you summon a lot of power and speed with the less amount of motion needed. Something Bruce Lee was doing with his one-inch punch. That shit was referenced in DBZ with Goku versus Frieza in the second Dragon Ball Super movie. If Deku masters this quirk, it's gonna be so cool, so raw. Like, I can't wait to see him combine this with his other quirks and do nasty combos. Though he doesn't master it right now, so I think it's gonna bite him in the ass in this fight, because I doubt it's over. I think we are about to see a 180 in the situation, but hey, we'll see. Anyway, this chapter was a strong 8.5 out of 10. I had a lot of fun reading it. I need to know, what are your all predictions for next week? Please share them in the comment section down below. I will respond to everybody. I'll see you all next week.